Ladies and gentlemen, once again, welcome back to our channel. And the topic for today's JCL tutorial is JCL Referback Statement or Backward Reference. The complete JCL tutorial is divided into two sections. First one is Introduction to JCL Referback Statement. Then we'll talk about JCL Referback Syntax Detail. And in second section, we will focus on how to use referback in a JCL or in a JCL procedure. So ladies and gentlemen, before I start with today's presentation, I would request you all to do subscribe to our channel because we need your support to grow our channel. And if you have already subscribed to our channel, then I would like to say a big thank you for your subscription. So let's begin our today's presentation. So before I start with the definition of backward reference, let me just give an overview of JCL. So the term JCL stands for Job Control Language, and it is basically the command language of the ZOS operating system. JCL actually provides a mechanism for the program to read input and write output to the requested physical resources. A JCL generally include three kinds of job control statement. First one is job card or a job statement. Second is execute statement. And the third one is DD statements. Now, let's look at the definition of referback in a JCL. So a backward reference or a referback facility of JCL lets you copy information from the previous DD statements. Therefore, instead of coding all the required parameters to allocate a dataset, you can copy them from a previous DD statement. Now, let's say you want to allocate quite a lot of dataset with the same DCB information. So you can specify the DCB information on the first DD statement, and then probably you can use JCL referback statement on subsequent DD statement to copy the same DCB information from the first DD statement. Now, let's look at the advantage of using referback in a JCL. So the backward reference facility would definitely help you in saving time. And in fact, it is best used in a situation where several DD statements use the same parameters and you expect those parameter values to change frequently. So instead of changing value on all the DD statement, you only need to change value on the first DD statement. And finally, the referback statement on subsequent DD statement would automatically copy the change parameter value from the first DD statement. Now, let's move on to the next section, that is JCL referback syntax. And in this section, we will focus on how to use referback statement in your JCL and what are the different parameters for which you can use referback to copy detail from the previously defined steps. As you know, that DD statements in JCL are used to define the dataset. They are generally used to specify the characteristics of the file, and you can use JCL referback statement to copy the characteristics information from the previous DD statements. Now, let's have a quick glance of JCL referback syntax. So as you know, that JCL referback syntax is fairly simple and easy to understand. So the syntax begins with a parameter name, and it could be any of the parameter which is listed below. After that, you have an equal sign followed by an asterisk. Then you have a dot. After that, you have a step name dot DD name. So step name is optional, and it is only required if the DD statement you are referring to is in a previous job step. Otherwise, you can use asterisk dot DD name if you're using the JCL referback statement within the same job step. And remember, there are following statements that cannot be referenced with the help of JCL referback statement. For example, DD star statement in DCB, DSN or a volume parameter. DD dummy statement in a volume or a unit parameter. Nested JCL procedure statement and sysout DD statements. So these are a couple of examples that cannot be referenced in your JCL referback statement. Now let's move on to the next section, that is JCL referback examples. So here's a sample JCL which is executing a program called TREMP01. It is using an input master file and creating three output files. First one is output mast and then you have EMP report and text report, right? So if you look at the first file, that is output mast, it is actually a sequential file with a record format of fixed block, logical record length of 80 and block size of 800. The next file is employee report, and I've created this file with the help of like parameter. So I've used like parameter to copy the properties of this particular file from the existing file, that is tp.emp.text.file.report, right? So this is an existing file which is already present in the system. Now let's move on to the next file, that is text report. Again, it's a report file, and I've used the referback statement to copy the DCB properties of the previous statement, that is emp o mast, that is an output master file, right? So it's pretty simple. You need to just specify the parameter, that is DCB, followed by an equal sign, then you have asterisk dot emp o mast. So this is actually a DD name. And in case if I am referring to a previous step of this particular JCL, then definitely I have to specify the step name followed by a DD name. So we have a separate example in next slide, so you can have a good understanding of how exactly you need to specify in that scenario. So here's a sample JCL which is executing two separate program in different steps. So first step is executing a program called TREMP002, and in step 2 it is executing a program called TREMP003. And in second step, I want to use a file which was used in the previous step. So in order to use the same file, what I've done is that on step 2 EMP account DD name, I've specified DD DSN followed by equal sign, then you have asterisk dot step 01 dot DD name, that is EMP mast. So this is how you are informing system that use the same file which was used in step 1 DD name EMP mast. Right? So ladies and gentlemen, this marks an end to our today's presentation, and in case if you have any question related to referback statement in JCL, then do mention that in comment section and I would respond back to your questions after this presentation. And I would also request you all to do subscribe to our channel, because we need your support to grow our channel. And if you like this video, then please give us a thumbs up. Thank you so much.